All right, here's a little feature called Quick Maths, which might be useful to you if you find it quite difficult using some of the selection tools, which some people do. Some people do find difficulty with that. So let's try it with the Quick Mask. This is what we do: how to select the outline of this parrot so that we can perhaps change the background later on. All right, here's the Quick Mask tool here. Just click it once and then choose a brush, and I'll just make this brush a little bit bigger by using my bracket tool. Just paint somewhere on the image and you can see what happens here. You get this kind of red mask effect. Now don't worry about the colour, because the colour's completely irrelevant. This is just showing you where the actual mask is going to be. So I've just done that there. Now look what happens if I click back on the Quick Mask tool. Now you can see everywhere that you painted has become a selection. So let's just click back on it, back to in the Quick Mask mode again, and continue with this. Now what I'd like to do with this is just get the outline of the parrot and then fill the thing in later. So I'll make it slightly smaller. That makes it easier for me to sort of get a clear outline. Now I'm doing this pretty quick, so maybe you can, do it a bit more accurately when you try this, but I'll do that. I'm going across here and I'm just going up there, round the edge, and just do that and up. And now it'll make it a bit easier for me to fill it in, now that I've got this outline, complete outline. So here we go. So we do this here, we fill it in and use the brush tool to just, find any bits that I might have missed there. Just there, like that. Okay. And here, because that had a soft edge, you see, it leaves a strange line effect there. Right, so let's just look at that. There we go. And as you can see, it's not too bad, but I've made a few mistakes here. So let's just click back. And here you'll notice that I kind of went too far. I went too far into the background there. And this is the good bit. This is a good bit, because you can just get the eraser and make it a bit bigger and select and just rub out the bits that are wrong, which makes it nice and easy. And because it's semi-transparent, you can see, exactly where you're going. And now get the paintbrush again and just repair it, just paint it in. So that makes it easy. Okay, another little test you can do to see if you've missed any is if you just double click on the Quick Mask tool. See where it says 50%? That's the opacity of the actual mask itself, not the selection, just mask. So if we just make that 100% and click OK, you can see when you go back a solid mask. All right, so any bits that you missed are very clearly noticeable, and you can just do that. There we go. And here we need to just fix that and fix that there. Okay, that's nearly everything. So just click back on there and we've got a fairly good selection. Now there's a little bit there that I actually need to cut out, because there's a little bit of the background showing through there. So let's go back again. Now I'll need to just put it back on 50% so that I can see exactly what I'm doing. So now I think I just need to zoom in to this area here and just select it there, because I'm going to use the eraser here to just kind of remove the mask from that small triangle. So I'll use the bracket to actually decrease the size of the brush, and then I can just delete this bit here. Okay, so I'm just removing, rubbing out that with the eraser. Actually, I think I've gone a bit too far, so no problem, I'll just paint it back in again. So there we go. Just paint that bit back in there because I think that's the background there. Well, this is really easy now. And now just click back on and have a look there. So we've got a nice hole there. There's just a little bit here that we need to get rid of. So back to the mask and paint that bit in there that I've missed. And any other bits. This could be a good opportunity to just scroll around it now and just check that I've not missed any bits. And we'll zoom out again by just double clicking on the zoom tool there. And I'll just hold the Alt key down to zoom back down to it. So there's a good section of our image with the quick mask. So now let's just go back to the quick mask, click on it, and there you go, nice selected. Oh, there's a bit down there that I've missed, so I'll just do that. Sorry, there, erase that little bit there, just there. Okay, and there was just a little bit there that I need to just fix. There we go. Right, click on there. Ooh, that little bit there. Okay, back on the quick mask, paint that bit in. And there we go. So we've got a nice clean selection there. Now I just want to make sure that I don't have this cut out so that it looks like a cardboard cutout. I want a nice soft edge. So I'm going to go to select. I'm going to go to modify and feather. I'm going to give it about 5 pixels, that's all. Just this kind of softness around it. You won't see anything happen yet. And now I'm going to make a new layer from just this so that later on I can put something else into the background, yeah? So here we go, I'm going to go layer, new, and layer via copy, okay? I could do cut, and that would leave a kind of hole where it was in the background, but I'm going to do copy. And now you can see, on the layers palette, if I turn the background layer off, there's a fairly nice cutout of our parrot. At this stage, you could actually get the eraser tool, if there's some bits you're not happy with, and just kind of, just very carefully, just finish it off there. Any bits you're not quite happy with, but mostly, you know, you've done it. And this is a transparent, it's on a transparent background, so it means we can now put anything we like in the background. So if I just turn that one off, you see it is there. If I get the moving tool, it's completely separate. Look, there it is. It's completely separate. Okay, so I'm going to turn that one off and just go back to the background. And I'm just going to do something silly with it. I could fill it with a completely new background, or I could distort it in some way, or I could just have a plain background. I'm just going to just for fun here, I'm just going to go distort and see what we can play around with here with this. I'll click OK on there. So it's using the colours of the image to sort of, you know, it's distorted in this strange kind of way. Let's do, I don't know, let's try another one here. Let's try twirl. And we'll just kind of mess around a little bit with this. That should be fun. And maybe I'll just blur it a little bit as well. So filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and just give it a bit of blur there like that. And maybe even something else. Let's go mad. Let's do ocean ripple. Let's try that. See how that looks. This is, we get a different window here so that you can see the result of what you've done. That's quite a dramatic change there. We'll click OK. Alright. There we go. Right, let's put the original back and see what we've got. And that looks rather nice. So that's a new background for our parrot or macaw. Very nice effect there. And that's mostly using this wonderful Quick Mask tool. So try that. In.